Hello and welcome back to Blacker Couch Reviews. I'm your host, Christina. We're back to discuss another episode of The Flash. It is starting to feel real that the show is going off in 5 episodes. And I'm happy that I enjoyed this episode. And it's on a good upward trajectory for me right now. I'll take it. Partners in Time was written by Sarah Tarkoff and Joshua V. Gilbert, directed by Ed Freeman. It's also not surprising that Barry and Iris being at the center of the episode kind of makes it easier to enjoy because we're bouncing off of two of our favorite characters, so there's of course a bias there. However, I've seen episodes of The Flash where Iris and Barry are not there, and I have enjoyed them. But I will say, it feels in the last season more pressing to want to focus on them than it has ever done. And I've addressed it probably enough, but it still stands. Before we jump into the recap, wherever you listen to this podcast, Podbean, Stitcher, iTunes, Spotify, go down to the rating section, drop some stars, leave a review. My social media will be there as well. If you want to send feedback, blackgirlcouch@gmail.com. We begin the episode in 2123 at the Flash Museum, where Darth Vader is attempting to make a robbery. I want to clown on the Flash Museum because it was looking real good in season 5 at least, but I understand budget reasons. He can deactivate, or they can, because we don't know. I put it as a he because I was thinking it was Darth Vader. Deactivate a computer system, but forgot the laser sounding the alarm. So out they dip into a portal. This event lines up when the DOE inspected the building, and they really wanted us to know and pay attention to this particular part of the plot because we're all 8 years old. Barry, so eager to be a dad, has already painted the crib. That color was ugly. Can we all not agree? Is that supposed to be excess colors? Because that's not gold, that's yellow and purple, and I don't like it. And stocked the freezer with Nora's favorite ice cream. I love Iris was a star this episode. I'm just gonna throw it out there because I know I was talking about my girl, about how checked in she was in some of the episodes. I could tell she was all the way present for this episode. And I think it is. It's more like, shit, if y'all ain't gonna write stuff good enough for me to tackle, then why should I put in so much effort? At this point, I'm just cashing them checks. But I could tell she had fun with this episode and she got to be comedic. And I think that Candace Patton really likes to stretch her comedic muscles. And she just had so many great lines and facial expressions and reactions to things, as with the ice cream. Like, is that why our freezer has a whole bunch of cookie dough ice cream in it? Well, you know, it's her favorite when she's 23, sir. Iris still rocking them locks. It's actually really shameful it took us a whole decade to fucking get here, but I'm not gonna complain or be petty other than the pettiness in which I already just shown. But no, she looks gorgeous. And I saw the photo. I'm about to put that on something. That could be a ringtone. Somebody's ringtone. Go get that picture. She is craving vanilla bean ice cream. But before she even got it out of her mouth, Barry was already back with the ice cream and a spoon. Like, she's like, yes. Yeah, I know. I love how in this moment, there's like, yeah, I know I got swag. He's not pretending that he is checking all the boxes, all of them. He also isn't the only sap in the relationship, as Iris gifts him with a magazine featuring his dad in mint condition, something he mentioned 6 months ago as he lost his copy as a kid.
Aw, bitch.
That's what we do, boo. That is what we do. Just being all types of spoiling each other. I can't stand y'all, gold standard. Lovely seeing them as being domestic and happy. I'm sure a lot of people who have been requesting these types of interactions should be pretty happy. Iris is sitting there in her slippers. I actually really wanted that sweater, though. Where'd you get that? You need to drop that in my inbox. No, just put the sweater in a fucking bag and mail it to me. Don't tell me where you got it. I probably can't afford it. Like, Candace is going to reach out to me. So these are conversations I have with myself. Moving on to Barry getting a notification because he has scheduled a mold inspection so Star Labs would be safe for his daughter, not the people that work there. When she's born in 7 whole months. Mark walked out on Khione, which is a nice update since I didn't watch any of their scenes. And now it's on to the second daughter Carla never wanted, not to mention hers is dead.
Oh, that's awkward.
They very clearly checked that box off because that actress was not coming back, but they wanted to address it. And I'm fine with that. I'm absolutely fine with that because how do you say, hey, your daughter's dead. You didn't know she died. She didn't say goodbye. Sure, this is pretty hard, but I, who look like her with blue hair, have taken her place. Barry sends everyone home, but is surprised that instead of just mold inspection, there's 3 other people that have showed up who realize that this place hasn't been inspected since the particle accelerator, so maybe we need to do a DOE inspection. Iris walked down that damn hallway with the open dish like she was at home. That dude was like, that smells delicious.
Get back, motherfucker, you don't know me like that.
Get back, motherfucker, you don't know me like that.
Geek, geek, whoop, whoop. I ain't playing around. Make one false move, I take you down. Get back, motherfucker, you don't know me like that.
Get back, motherfucker, you don't know me like that.
I even love the way she walked down that hallway like she just smashed that shit and it hit the spot. Then gave the blackest response ever to a white man asking, who are you? Hungry. And you are?
If my answers frighten you, Vincent, then you should cease asking scary questions.
Then after Howard introduced himself, she's like, my bad. He's like, I thought you was resting. Yeah, I couldn't wait for this casserole. Question, how did you show up, ma'am? How did you get here so quick? Y'all telling me Cisco don't have them devices still around her house that she is utilizing? Iris offers to help because she knows bureaucratic jackassery when she sees it. So into the Star Labs, the Star Lab, they go. One dude came down like, no mold up there, man. Iris is like, I could have told you that. Again, on point with the clapbacks. Like, you didn't need to be that extra, sir. Also laughed when Khione was like, I could have told you there was no mold up there because I just know. The team scent is a little weird, with Iris thinking they remind her of sitcom characters. And they also, at least the one chick, didn't know where a breaker box was. I did laugh with them sharing the joke with Barry being inspectors coming this fall. After taking them, that reminded me of Nora so much. It really, really did, because that's what she, something she would say. After taking them to the breaker box, they find themselves back in the speed lab with the inspector, Howard, not amused. When Howard accuses Alan, which, why are you starting to call me by my last name? Not Mr. Alan, Alan. When he calls him that, like, I don't like this funny business, Ira says, Barry's not even a funny guy, like, at all. You've hurt me. Grant's face was perfect in response, like, yeah, she doesn't really mean that, right? Iris and Barry literally just mimic each other before walking right back into the speed lab. What in the H-E double hockey sticks is a blast from the past in cursing? A grandfather clock that wasn't there previously chimes with homegirl like this shit would go for dollars. What was her name? Jane? She's like, this would go for some dollars at the Antique Rose Show. Howard thinks they are pranking him and that his coworker is in on it and that they have identical rooms. And they let him think that before having a little sidebar with Barry unable to get a signal out to contact the team. And Iris asking, what the fuck? What is going on? This doesn't feel like an attack or an illusion from another meta. And Iris tells him, we need to hurry because our future speedster needs a snack. Barry wants to run to the future.
No, hell no.
I also laughed out loud and cackled and hackled. And maybe rolled around on the floor at her immediate no. But because Barry is Barry and Iris is Iris, he's like, come on, let me do it. Let me do it. I'm out of options. Let me do it. She's like, fine, fine, fine. I'm going to let you fuck up. And then when you come back and you fuck up, I'm not even going to get mad at you for fucking up or trying this thing that you knew was not going to work. Because really, I'm hungry and I need you to bring me back a snack. Something with pistachios. That's when we move to the West household, where Allegra and Chester are playing Scrabble, arguing over the word za, and Allegra's fears being outed as a light meta. This would have worked a lot better if their chemistry wasn't stale as shit. But then Cecile came in. Well, first the L word got dropped ever so casually. Then it was awkward. Then Cecile came in and she'd been using her powers for so long, she don't know how to read a damn room. And Allegra was like, yeah, you should stay. You should totally stay. Let's play. Let's play a game. Let me use you as a buffer. And I'm going to totally allow you to do that because I really need someone to drink wine with so I don't seem as depressive. Actually, I really thought they was going to have, and I wish they would. I should have put this on my wish list last year of Cecile getting drunk because I think that shit would be hilarious. And that's where I thought this was going. Cecile was going to get drunk and then they was going to have to help her. And then that was going to have them have that conversation. But alas, no. Iris, back at Star Labs, makes excuses for Barry speeding around upstairs. I know they can't see because he's supposed to be faster than light, but we can see. But eventually, they cannot keep the prank lie going when a wave of time, it seems, hits everyone, changing Iris into a goddess. And Barry, he fell from the tube with a Star Trek t-shirt a Star Trek cosplay on. And Iris still thinking it's Star Wars. Oh, babe. It's been like 6 years and she's just like, Star Wars? Mm-mm. He doesn't even bother. He just looks at her like, we've had this conversation before. Barry has no choice but to reveal he's the Flash, which explains all this crazy shit happening and at least gets everyone on board with, okay, well, that makes sense. That makes more sense than what doesn't. Jane, who can do calculations, says, oh, now that I know that you're the Flash, after this, can I study your quantum biochemistry?
What the hell did you just say?
Bitch, I hope the fuck you do. You'll be a dead son of a bitch, I tell you that.
After the whiteboard is brought out, because why not? Howard figures it's the time magnet because he knows his sci-fi, with Iris concluding something was up to thievery, and since no one else has come and gone in Star Labs, the thief be in this room. Barry said, let's not jump to conclusion. Nope, let's test the theory and see who emitting radiation. I'm glad you have it over there, Jane. Bring it out. Allegra kind of treats Chester like shit, wanting to keep playing a game. Even Cecile at this moment's like, I'm going to go upstairs. No, I need you to stay. And then she sat down. She's like, if there's about to be drama, I'm about to sit here and watch this shit. I wish I had my popcorn. But Chester says, it's okay, Allegra, I'm just going to leave. While they all seem back at Star Labs to pass the radiation test, Howard balks at being accused, but his innocence is proven shortly when he turns into a statue. Jane said, nah, he dead. He scattered through time. I was like, damn. She said so casually. Apparently, he wasn't a close colleague. The one who didn't know what a breaker box was the one I was thinking was to blame, and who also coincidentally blames Iris, who looked like she was about to clock her with that scanner, and leaves Jane to do her equations. Barry says, sidebar. Barry, shouldn't you be at that board with her, though, with these equations? Like, clearly you understand. Barry and Iris have a moment where he apologizes by themselves up in the speed tube for doing the thing he knows ain't gonna help, but can't help himself from doing anyway, as well as his desire to build a crib 7 months in advance. Iris is like, yeah, but I got my problems too, because my plan atomized Al Howard, even though your plan was right, and admits that she's been in denial about how things are different. She's tired. Her body is changing. She's hungry all the time. She's got pregnancy brain where she says something and then she don't remember that she said it. She just wants to go back to her old self. She's stuck in the past and he's racing towards the future. And also, I really want cookie dough ice cream. You mean vanilla bean? Yeah, you see, pregnancy brain. This revelation brings them to who their time thief is. Thanks, Mrs. Flash. When Tao is called out, who is aka Lady Kronos, she reveals herself and turns those two other poor, didn't do anything to anyone, people into knowns. Jane and I never figured out who the other last guy was. After some bickering back and forth over just putting it back, she says she's the best time thief, but then wants to just use it to steal anything by having it summoned to her. Don't you think that takes all of the fun out of the thievery part? But if you're retiring, why would you need to go back to thieving? You don't make sense. And I will say the bickering back and forth only for her to be like, fine, fuck. I'll just go back and put it back and I'll get arrested. But you'll be alive after revealing that she's the one that actually needs help, because she will be the first one that gets atomized before she can even harm Iris. Even though she still could have harmed Iris. I didn't care. It didn't make sense. I still liked it. Even her little makeup and her little cloak still had its effect. The inspectors also don't recall when Barry outed himself, because they show back up when time is reset. So they haven't been murdered, and that was nice. We love the Flash. That's why we call it the Speed Lab. He's handsome. Really, really very. Then the three OG cast members still remaining, Grant, Candace, and Danielle, discuss the day's events and go for cheese fries with Carla not wanting another daughter but a friend. Allegra goes to Chester, and I thought that this was worthwhile because it finally did address my issue, was the fact that Allegra is, I mean, Chuck feels like a doormat. The fact that she even just calls him Chuck. Even Cecile was like, Chester. Just to remind everyone, that's his real name. I know, it's their thing. It's their thing, whatever. He's not bothered by it. Why should I? But the fact that she admits, look, I'm the one with the baggage and I keep putting that shit on you and I ain't right. I do love you too. And I appreciate you being patient with me. I've lost a lot of people. We didn't need all the flashbacks. And I don't want to lose you too. But that's also life. I get all of those things that people say. But that is the point of living. Okay? So either you want to live or you want to die. Because those are effectively your, or oh, I'm never going to get close to anything. You're not living. You're not living in existence. Maybe scientifically. At the end of the episode, Barry tries to help Iris with her ice cream, but she ain't having it. So he gets his own and they toast to Vanilla Bean since he filled the freezer with her favorite instead of their daughter's and will allow Nora to tell him when he likes cookie dough. Living in the moment. I give this episode a 10 out of 10. I think it's not the first 10 I've given out this season. I'm pretty sure it went to the premiere. But I thought consistently through. I didn't fast forward anything. I was able to watch it. And it was enjoyable. Even the people I'm not the biggest fan of, they had understandable, logical arcs that allowed them to, you know, earn their paychecks too. We do have feedback, so let's hop into the mailbag.
Mail, motherfucker!
What up, Stina? It's Mimi. This is feedback for The Flash. I believe this is episode 9 of season 9. I actually like this episode, and I think I've realized the difference between episodes that I really like and episodes that I really don't like. At first, I thought it was episodes that just didn't have Iris in it. But that's not true, because last week's episode, I honestly could have done without. It was not my favorite. I watched it half-heartedly, and I really didn't even feel like giving feedback for it, because this is the last season. I don't want to badmouth them. I feel like after we got the Batman Flash debacle, I didn't already forget what that villain's name was. That's how much lackluster it was. I was like, you know what? If I don't enjoy an episode, I'm just not going to send feedback, because at this point, I'm not going to bash my show. I love me some Flash. I don't know why this season's fallen short. I don't know. I'm still going to support it. But I don't want to badmouth it, because this is their last season and there ain't no coming back from this. But this episode was great. And like I said, I realized the problem. It's when I don't have any kind of team up between Barry and Iris. This is why I love season 1 so much, and season 2, especially season 3. Season 1, yes, Iris didn't know Barry was the Flash, but we still got Barry and Iris interaction, or the Flash and Iris interactions, and it was just, it just makes a difference. And I don't know if that's my biased heart talking. It could absolutely possibly be. I don't want to pretend like I'm infallible to being biased. I've come to that realization thanks to you, Christina. I be dragging you a lot, but you know, you do point out some very valid points, and it makes you stop and think to try and look at things a different way. Because like I've told you 1,000 times, when I watch a show, I watch it just straight on the surface. So it's something I wouldn't have never even thought to even consider if someone else had pointed out to me. But since you did point out, you know, about, you know, people having biases, now that I understand it, it's the same in my nursing practice. You have to understand what your biases can be or are, and or are, in order for you to be able to, you know, not use them improperly. Everybody has biases. It's something that's in human nature, but you can't use them to like dislike or like someone, and you know, treat them a certain way, you know. And that's something that I am trying to understand. So like I said, it could absolutely be the reason why I don't like any episodes where Barry and Iris aren't working together. But this episode, even though it was so randomly bizarre, because it was like 20, like 72 or something like that. I was like, Nora and Bart ain't even like, they not even like the Flashes or whatever the hell their names are anymore, because they're old as hell. Like, they, granted, they could be alive. They'll probably be alive in 2072, but they not actively being superheroes, not at that age. Like, I mean, I guess it's possible they could age very slow, but that's pretty old. Like, what would they be like in their 60s? Like, young? I don't know. I don't know how speedsters age. Whatever, it doesn't even matter. But I was like, that's pretty far into the future. And then like Barry decided he was gonna get the Star Labs like looked at. It's like, has it really been 9 years? Y'all don't gotta get a yearly inspection, especially after the particle accelerator exploded. That seems like pretty funny. And then like we see the year, you know, 2023. It's like, y'all ain't had the Star Labs looked at again in that long? Like, geez, either people are terrified to go into that motherfucker, or Barry be paying people off, and it could be either or. Because how are you a research facility that literally had a particle accelerator explode, and y'all don't think to get this looked at? I mean, I guess it's better late than never, but that blew me. Like, I loved the way we got to see Iris and Barry interact with each other, the way they were looking at each other, communicating without words. I love how Iris just knew, like, let's come up with some lies to explain some things. Like, the look she was given, I don't know, this is the Candace Patton that I'm used to. Like, I seriously feel like the way she was being in the previous episodes was a like a director type thing. I don't think it had anything to do with her acting. I think it was honestly because they wanted her to be that way, because this is a Candace that we're used to. And just a side note, pregnant Iris is hilarious. The way she don't play about her food, I know that exact feeling. I was not one of those people who was throwing up all the time, who was sickly, like, that didn't gain weight. I gained entirely too much weight because I could not stop eating. Like, I was hungry all of the time. All of the time. Like, I could literally eat every 2 hours. And if I didn't, I would feel like I was starving. So I felt that. I mean, I know it sounds like stupid to say, but I wish I was one of those people who had morning sicknesses and that was throwing up the first 3 months, because then I wouldn't have gained 60 pounds. I could not stop eating, so I know exactly what Iris felt. And then, like, the emotion, like, the fact that she's having pregnancy brain this early really lets me think that maybe, like, we, you know, I'm, like, almost positive she's going to be having the twins, because I, like, the level of hormones that you have is, like, it's like, you do get a downpour of hormones in the beginning, but a lot of, like, the pregnancy brain, you know, from, like, the hormones that you're getting speeds up in the second trimester, because you're getting, you have more hormones, because you're, literally sustaining a life. Like, it takes a lot to keep your body pregnant, but once the baby starts developing, like the fetus develops into a baby, it takes on more. So, you know, her body is doing double the work, and I'm assuming having a speedster is gonna like super speed up everything, which is probably why she's hungry all the time. So I'm thinking that, you know, we are gonna get the tornado twins. I personally don't want them to be named Dawn and Dawn, because I think those are stupid names. I think I said that already. But I'm just really excited about, you know, the prospect of them finding out they're having twins. And I really hope Khione don't say anything, because I know she only 8 weeks old, but she be just running her mouth. Like, you need to learn to read the room. And I wish somebody would point that out to her. Like, she clearly doesn't understand and be like, look, I understand that you know some things, and we don't know why you know, and apparently we don't care why you know, but can you just keep some things to yourself? Because some things are not your business. And it's like, it's very rude and inappropriate for you to just be blurting people's business out. Some things we don't want everybody to know. Some things we don't want each other to know. So I'm going to need you to mind your business. And I would really like someone to point that out to her. But, you know, that's neither here nor there. It didn't make me dislike the episode, even though she is some apparently upset that Mark walked out on her. Girl, good riddance. Fuck that guy. And you, of all people, he tried to kill you. So you should really get over it. I loved how, I don't know if you saw it. I saw someone on Twitter noticed it too, because it sent me. I was laughing for probably like 5 minutes. When that one of the people in Star Labs was like, when after Barry decided he was going to tell everybody he's a Flash, because, you know, why not? And she was like, I would love to study your biochemistry. And I was like, first, like, to me, I was like, I feel like that's inappropriate. But then the look that Iris gave her, I was cackling. Because the one thing about Iris West Allen, she don't play about her man. Like, she, like, looked over Barry's shoulder in the side eye. The girl didn't see it, but I saw it. It was hilarious, because I felt the same way. Like, oh, ma'am, no. That's not something you... We just met, bitch. You don't know me. Don't be asking my man to study his anything. That was so funny. I don't know who wrote this episode, but it was really good. But one thing I did not like was how... they, like, I felt like they dumbed down Barry to make that other lady seem like the smart one. But I feel like Barry probably could have came up to those same conclusions. Like, maybe he don't know all of those theories, but, like, it should have been her giving out her theoretical information and Barry using it to come up with a solution. Because I feel like Barry was just as smart as her, if not smarter. But when that lady who was clearly not an electrician asked for the breaker box, even I know what a breaker box is, and she didn't know what that was, that should have been a dad giveaway. They should not have used that as the beginning, because that was, I was like, I know it's her. And then when it didn't work on her, I was like, it must not be working or something, because she's not an electrician. How do you not know basic? Like, she didn't even come up with a good explanation. She could have been like, I'm sorry, I had a brain freeze or something. Anything to, like, acknowledge that you know that you should know that, but you don't. And honestly, I have brain freezes, or, like, sorry, I'm tired. My mind isn't working right. Anything like that, but something. But for her to just not know what that is, and then it takes them all the way to the end to figure out that she's not really an electrician, y'all should have known that already. And I didn't like how they made Barry stupid in that moment. Even if, like, maybe Barry wasn't around and Iris, you know, with pregnancy brain, she could have easily forgot that happened, and then brought it up later, you know, something like that. But to make it so that everybody heard it and Barry was there and then nobody even said anything, like, that right there was one of the only things that I didn't like about this episode, because it's like, I know she did it, and I feel like if I could guess who did it, it's pretty obvious. I didn't quite understand why those people were replaced with statues of gnomes, and the one guy was placed with the statue of a Greek god. Like, I'm not quite sure what that was about, but I know it has something to do with that staff she stole. And her reasoning for stealing it was so stupid. Like, if you are a thief, I'm just theorizing out loud, and you steal something that literally fucks up your life and then sends you into the past, really far in the past, and you can't get back, and then it could kill you. Why are you still holding on to it? But this is my retirement fund. Like, not if you die. Like, I don't know. I feel like they could have probably given her a better reason of stealing it or something. Because, you're holding on. Like, if it's, life or death or something like that, then I understand you holding on so long. And then Barry can use his Barry-ness and give you a lecture about, there's always another way. And then, okay, you're right. If I die, I can't help anybody. Okay, whatever. But just because I want the money and I don't want to steal anymore, this is going to get me my retirement fund. Not if you die in 2023, you moron. Like, that in itself kind of irritated me. But that was the only other thing about the episode that I really didn't care for. But like I said, overall, I liked it so much that those little things didn't even bother me. The whole Chuck and Allegra thing, that relationship is annoying. I'm glad they love each other, and I'm glad Chuck finally gonna get some. Good for him. I'm proud of them. But it's a relationship I can honestly do without. I like that they're giving Cecile something to do. She gonna be Allegra's mama. I'm cool with that. I'm glad she's still getting a check, the actress, because Jesse left. So good for her. But I'm going to need this trajectory to be the same. I want you guys to do this. Focus on Barry and Iris. Focus on their relationship. Let them do things together. Let them team up. Let them fight crime together. And then have little sprinkles in the background. Because that's what got you guys here. This is what made this series so great. Candace and Grant. Iris and Barry. Let's keep this. Because y'all don't have that many episodes left, and I'm going to need y'all to not fuck this up. If the last several episodes are really good, I think we're going to end on a great note, and I'm 100% okay with that. We could just pretend like these last couple episodes didn't even happen. So I really, really, really want this to be the trajectory that they go, and I want this to stay like this. So I'm going to end it here. Until next time, love, peace, hair grease, and black girl magic. Queen of the Couch, meet me out.
Thank you, Queen Mimi, for your thoughts on the episode. So Candace's or Iris's side eye was the best part of the episode. I don't know if that part or the one when she was like hungry and you are. I can't even tell you how many times that has been my response to people I don't know. And if I'm in the mood, there's too many things that touch too close to home in this episode. The walking around with the dish. Oh, so much. I think it's fine that the dynamic that builds upon everything else is Iris and Barry since the beginning of the season. It is what they built the season around. And thus, that bias is understandable. And I liked your elaboration on the subject, as we have discussed. It's one of those things. It's like, whether we want to admit it or not, well, some of us are better admitting it or not, clearly. We as people are consistent works in progress. We don't ever stop growing as people. And even the best of us can still find flaws. But the only thing that you can do is be aware of them and try to work on them. That's not going to say you're going to be perfect and that you're not going to slip up. And that's why people are so harsh and critical nowadays. It's like, God, the culture right now in America sucks. And it has for the last 4 or 5 years. And a lot of people love to just throw it on social media. But I just think, ultimately, it's the culture outside of it. I see it at work. I see it, in the streets where people just want to choose a side, and stick to their very, clear objectives without any fluency. or fluidity of person, and that is just not great. Even if you don't agree with someone, you at least should understand where they're coming from. Yeah, that inspection don't make no sense. Why the fuck? If anything, the DOE should be more on top of this place since, you know, it created a whole city of metahumans. And girl, you don't want that sickness, no. Yeah, you may have gained all that weight, but I assure you, the sickness would have been worse. I wish I was hungry like that. I really do. I don't think I had cravings other than that one time, very briefly, I had that, I think I've talked about this before, that raisin bran craving for about 2 weeks. That's because it's the only thing that came to me, and then I would just throw it up, and then I stopped liking raisin bran. I have not eaten raisin bran since I've been pregnant. Officially ruined that for me. So all I would eat was popsicles, and I hated it. I hated it. There is nothing worse than throwing up several times a day and it coming up out of nowhere. It's not great. Not great at all. And that was 4 fucking months straight. Okay? Okay. I would have preferred to be eating up the whole entire kitchen sink. At least that didn't hurt. And because they don't do right, these hospitals, by pregnant women, particularly if you're Black, you don't get any help for these types of issues. That's fine. It's normal. 4 months fucking straight I've been eating popsicles, motherfucker. I've lost 20 pounds. How is this normal? Moving on. I think the whole Caitlin Frost, you know, maybe Caitlin was secretly attracted to Mark. Who knows? But the goal objective of that attraction seems to be part one, try to kill me. Part two, all of a sudden, really be into you. And why? Who gives a fuck about Mark? You don't even know that man. You were just born 8 days ago. Bruh. What kind of connection do you really think y'all had? I also don't know about the gnomes. The statue made sense. I don't know about the grandfather clock, because it's like, it looks just recently made. I guess that's supposed to be an old timey thing. I'm like, oh, come on now. Fuck off. I don't know about the gnomes, but the statue is supposed to be pulling things from time. Okay, sure, you're dressing in different outfits. He's turned into a statue, but the gnomes is what threw me, and the clock, if I'm being honest. I think they just wanted to bring us back to fucking Stranger Things. And you know what? Someone in the prop department was thinking that exact fucking thing. I guarantee you. I'm also with you about how much the convolution of the last 5 minutes of this story played. Like, why did she even need to kill the other two? She's like, what? And even Barry's like, why did you need to kill them? Don't you think more hostages would help get you your way? Because Iris, you heard her. You might as well just bury yourself. Put yourself in a fucking ground, because you're already dead. So that's not going to work out. And it really didn't even seem like she was supposed to be an evil person. That's what they said. This doesn't feel like an attack. Or they did say it. Maybe it's an illusion meta, and it was an illusion meta. I don't know. I did have questions though, like, yeah, Barry could have been at the board. Yeah, so I agree with that. But I also know that Barry, that's why he has a team. I love Barry and Iris, but they ain't always on their A game. No, they not. That's not what the receipts say. So it would have been better if they just would have stuck at, I'm here and I need, good God, but I don't even know what just happened to my voice. I'm not even editing it out. But I'm here. I know what happened. I'm stuck here now. Now I have to be stuck here under disguise because I stole what I stole, because she got there and then she was able to steal what she needed, but then she couldn't get back. That was her problem. So she could have just taken them hostage after being found out and been like, okay, I need you to charge my thing. And then he's like, well, I'm going to need you to get back up the staff because that's the only way that we're going to be able to fix this situation. And then maybe she had a minute of, but this is supposed to be my retirement. Da 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 da. And because thievery, let's be real, is a pretty, up until she started killing people, I wouldn't say it's the worst crime in the world, right? And that could have been it. We didn't need to have the whole back and forth, and she didn't need to kill anybody to prove that she was serious. And like she enjoyed it too. That threw it off. But as you stated, it took absolutely nothing away from my enjoyment of this episode. And I'm glad Cecile is being the mother to Allegra. She needs somebody to mother. I think that is all my thoughts. I enjoyed your feedback, as always. And I agree with you. I do hope that they continue this pace. Because that is what true fans of this show definitely want. And as stated, even when we are giving critique in even a harsh way, it is done with a certain love. We're here fucking 9 years later, 10 years later. That's not love. Okay. We've watched all 22 of these fucking episodes. Okay. 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 Right. So we're here wanting to be fans. It's not like we're here. It's not like you're trashing the show. I don't think critiquing is trashing. I think that if you don't like something, that means, unfortunately, you did not accomplish the goal at hand, you know, and that's fair. That's absolutely fair. And as long as you're given constructive criticism, that's also fair. It's not trashing. If it's unfortunately just a nothing but a negative turn that is shared, then that's just how it was, how it is. Let's just hope it ends better. And it feels as if, you know, it's not been the worst. It's been a terrible villain. But first and second episode, I mean, we've had 8, not 9, 8. And I would say out of those, 1, 2, I know you didn't like last week's, but I thought it was okay. 1, 2, and 3, 4. So 4 and 4, we're half and half, right? So no reason to panic yet. they usually do pretty good at the end. If you want to send feedback, blackgirlcouch@gmail.com. You can also like, share, and subscribe. Until next time, peace, hair grease, and black girl magic. Hustling. Every day I'm hustling. Whip it real hard, whip it.